I'm from the Department of Software Engineering in this building. And first of all, please be patient with my English, because this will be probably my longest English talk. I don't know. Okay. So I will talk about my dissertation about information extraction for the semantic web. And what will be probably interesting for you is that my solution is based on tools, linguistic tools connected with Prague Dependency Tree Bank project. And the implementation is based on integration of these tools with gate and inductive logic programming. So I will describe the problem of information extraction and especially about this problem in the context of the semantic web with few examples. Then I will concentrate on our solution, which is based on these linguistic tools and something about extraction rules and the semantic interpretation of extraction rules and learning of extraction rules and some notes about evaluation. And in the end, there will be some extended implementation details right about the tools from related to the Prague Dependency Tree Bank project and their integration with gates and with semantic technologies. So the task of information extraction is basically to find information in text, to pick the most useful bits and present them in a manner and right level of detail. On the other hand, semantic web should be a medium for exchange of information, and not only for humans like the contemporary web, but rather for software agents which should understand the content of the semantic web and integrate these data automatically and work with them. The main problem of the semantic web today and for many last years was that we have not much semantic data. It's better now, but still not always in the web is semantically understandable, semantically like in the terms of ontologies, semantic web ontologies, and so on. So, we are using information extraction for the semantic web. We want to use the automated potential of information extraction to produce the semantic data for the semantic web. Some introduction to semantic web. Probably many of you already know this, but semantic web is basically supported by semantic languages for ontologies, which are RDF and OVL. OVL is motivated by description logics, and it's based on three basic concepts like classes or concepts or a set of things. Then there are the predicates or relation between things, and the last category is instances, which are the content of the classes of the instances are the things. So RDF framework is built on triples: subject, predicate, object, which are named edges of named graph graph of RDF graph, and from these triples, the named oriented graph of the semantic web is built. There is an example of an ontology. It's a proton ontology, and it's basically a class hierarchy. We usually start from something like entity, then it's an abstract. An abstract usually maybe an address, a number, or happening, which is here, and it could be even situation, time interval, and here is an object, the third one, which can be an agent, organization, or person, group, location, etc. So this is a class hierarchy, which is the most known part of ontologies. Besides that, there is the instances, the actual data, which are described by terms of the classes of ontology. And between the things, between the instances, there are relations, which are not described on this picture. Now, what is actually semantic annotation? Connected with information extraction and semantic web, there are many related topics or disciplines. One is called semantic annotation. There is also something like ontology learning, which is basically learning of ontology schema from text, or ontology population is very popular, which is getting instances to the ontology from text. And semantic annotation is to do a mapping from text to an ontology. So we have here a small piece of text about some company XYZ, which announced a profit in third quartile. It's about $120 million, and it's in Bulgaria. And the decorated pieces in text are mapped to this ontology, and when a machine approaches such text, it can understand this text. It can understand that XYZ is a company because it's written in the ontology, and that it has HQ in London, etc. It also knows that Bulgaria is a country, and that a country is a location, etc. And also that UK is also a country, and so on. So, this semantic annotation we can do either manually or automatically, in an automated manner. And I will talk mainly about how to do in an automated manner, and how to do with Prague dependency tree bank tools. So there is one web page which is from our yearly motivation. It's about a car accident, and it's written in Czech. When I started doing my dissertation, there weren't any tools for processing English in Prague Dependency Tree Bank, so we started with Czech. And now we discovered that our method can be used for English as well. So the yearly motivation was in Czech, and we have here the extracted text from the web page and decorated the information which is interesting for us. So we know that it is about a fire, that it started at 2:13, that there were three amateur units, fishermen amateur units, that the action finished at 4:03 and that the damage was 8,000 crowns. So how to extract such information from text? Another example is in English. It is from Corporate Acquisition Events Corpora. And again, there are decorated information, which could be interesting. It's about acquisitions. So we have here Inred Purchaser, we have the Acquired in blue, and we have dollar amount, which is the subject of the acquisition, etc. So this one is mainly about named entity recognition and about deciding which named entity is in which rule in the text. So, something about our solution. If we have this motivation text and we are now especially interested about the amount 8,000 crowns of damage, then probably no one from you will be surprised that we have a tektogrammatical tree from the sentence Škodu vyšetřovatel přibližně vyčíslil na 8,000 korun in Czech and below in English. And from the tektogrammatical tree we can see that there are clear indices how to extract the actual information that the damage was 8,000 crowns. So the basic idea is to build a patterns or extract or tree queries to extract the information from trees, to extract the information based on the tree shape and tree information and information kept in the tree. So we did it, and we used the analysis tools from Prague Dependency Tree Bank project, and our rule-based extraction method is very, very simple use of something what you already know and you have. We use tree queries from NetGraph application, but you probably use rather the thread-based queries, but never mind. All the two things are very similar. For us, the choice of NetGraph was because it is implemented in Java and it was simple to use it. And also the tree queries from thread wasn't developed in the time when I started with my work. So when we want to use the information extraction to make from contemporary web the semantic web, then we have to start on the web and extract the text from web pages, then we use the linguistic tools to produce linguistic trees and linguistic annotations. Then, based on linguistic trees, we do the data extraction, which produces something we call raw data, and the raw data then has to be transported or translated to an ontology. We call this process semantic semantic interpretation. So I probably don't have to talk about this. The extraction method is based on PDT. We have also done some experiment with stand for dependencies. So the extraction method can work not only with PDE trees, but also with Stanford trees or any another similar trees. But it is usually based on dependencies. We don't have any experiments with phrase structure trees. These are the main tools we have to run in the preprocessing steps. First we do the tokenization, segmentation, morphological analysis, morphological tagging, then analytical parsing, analytical function assignment, and tectogrammatical analysis. Now all these tools are can be used within the TectoMT project, which is a great help for our work now. So after the end of the processing of all these tools, the tool result with such tectogrammatical trees, and we can extract the information from these trees. Our first approach is based on manually created rules. So, how to extract the information that two people have died during the accident? We can design such a, let's say, net graph query or extraction rule, which is very useful. It's a pattern on shape and also on node attributes. So we can design this extraction rules however we like. This is also useful because it's a graphical notion of an extraction query. It's much more better than a code and extraction rules like a bthread script, because this is easier. You don't have to be a pair programmer and so on. We can then evaluate such a query and extract the information from actual matches of such extraction rule on a tree. The names of the nodes are very useful for the extraction. So we can write some SQL-like query, select action type, tectogrammatical lemma, and negation, morphological type, injury manner, tectogrammatical lemma, and so on, from the previous extraction rule, and the software outputs such XML data, which can be seen as a structured output of the extraction method. Well, I have another example here, which is motivated in environment protection. We are interested in situation which are dangerous to the environment. So we look for sentences in which something exploited out to the environment, some danger liquid usually. This is an actual match of the extraction rule on a sentence. Nárazem se utrhlo hrdlo palivové nádrže a do potoka postupně vyteklo na 800 litrů nafty. The extraction rule matches with this tree, and we can easily find the matching nodes and and find the information here. So it was 800 liters of diesel, and it was into a water stream. And there is the raw output, raw data output of such extraction. Now we have some raw data extracted from text, but as we are in the semantic web environment, we want to have semantic data. We want to have the data in an ontology. So we do a semantic interpretation of extraction rules, which gives semantics to both, semantics to extraction rules and semantics to extracted data. So this is a mapping of all the nodes of an extraction rules, and we always say which linguistic attribute is mapped to the ontology, where to the ontology. So this is very, very elemental instance of an ontology of two classes, class for an incident and class for a participant. These two classes are related by the relation has participant, and there are some attributes of both classes. There is action mirror negation, action type, and there is participant type and participant quantity. It's just for demonstration purpose. The ontology is not very well designed, but this is the semantic data that could be extracted this way. So we have some identifier of an accident, and we know that action type was death, and it had participant which is a man, and quantity is two, which means two men died. And the another example is another incident with different identifier, but the information is negative because negation is true, and we know that the type is injury and the participant was driver. We didn't invest much time to this thing. In fact, this is not working. This is just a proposal, because we concentrated more on the automated learning of extraction rules. So this is just a design of the example ontology. When one wants to do such manual extraction, it is necessary to design the extraction rules, which is cyclic iterative process, starting usually with frequency analysis and selecting some keywords and looking into the trees and making the extraction rule more and more complex. So in the end, we have good coverage between the original sentences covered with just keywords and the sentences covered by the complex tree query. We have tested this approach on the fire department articles corpora. it's just text from the internet, from the web of Ministry of Interior of Czech Republic. We used about 800 articles and received about 470 matches of the extraction rule and 200 numeric values, which were just optional in the extraction rule. So now the more interesting part of the presentation, automated learning of extraction rules. We used inductive logic programming, which is a machine learning procedure for multi-relational learning. Probably you know classical relational learning algorithms like perceptrons or multilayer perceptrons or support vector machines or decision trees or all stuff like that. And all the tools work on just one table. It is very difficult to work with more complex structures like linguistic trees, which these learning algorithms. So we use inductive logic programming because it is not limited by one table, and it can naturally work with tree structures. But it's a rather heuristic and iterative method, so the learning is sometimes slow, and one has to tune the parameters and look for the balance between the time complexity of the learning method and the quality of the extraction rule. Inductive logic programming outputs rules which are strict. The rules doesn't use any weights or probabilities, so they have usually lower performance in terms of precision and recall and so on. But these rules are very easy for human to understand and modify. And these rules are as well very easy to share between different tools. It is not limited to use these rules just in the native tool which discovered them. I will show this later. So inductive logic programming works first you have to support it with a knowledge base with some facts, and you have also give the inductive logic programming positive and negative examples, which in our setting are positive and negative nodes of trees. So we give the ILP linguistic trees, and we give it also this tree node is positive example, this tree node is negative example. And the inductive logic programming will find such tree patterns or tree rules that will match only the positive example and will not match with the negative examples, with the negative nodes. So again, we start on web, we select some texts and produce linguistic trees. Then these trees are transformed to inductive logic programming background knowledge. And we have to have a human annotator who labels the text and marks the positive words in text, and he or she can also support semantic meaning of the marked points in text. Then the background knowledge and the positive and negative examples are used in the learning procedure, and the learning procedure produces extraction rules, which can in the end be used for extraction of information from any linguistically processed text. So the most interesting things here is the transformation of linguistic trees to logical representation, and there is also interesting fact that this human annotator doesn't have to be an expert in a linguistic field. He or she has to know just what to label in a text. So, from web page to linguistic trees to linguistic representation. I don't know if you are able to read this, but it's very simple. Every node of a tree has an identifier, and to the node identifier, the linguistic attributes are attached with functors. It's many of you probably can program in Prolog, so it's a Prolog database, fact database, and yeah. Here is that node 1 has a functor predicate. It has a semantic part of speech verb, a tectogrammatical lemma zranit, and so on. And then there are edges between nodes of a tree, just stated as edge between node 0 and node 1, and edge between node 1 and node 3, and between node 4 and node 5, and so on. And this representation is readable for inductive logic programming, and with positive and negative examples, it can find such rules that identify relevant nodes of trees. So we have like here a rule which identifies the image in a node A if the node A is connected with node B with lexical reference, and the node B have semantic part of speech, noun, quantity definite, and the node B is connected by tectogrammatical dependency with node C, and the node C is connected with node D, and node D has a tectogrammatical lemma vyšetřovatel or investigator in English. There is a problem with multi-word expressions. When we have something like 8,000 korun or 8,000 crowns, then in the tree it has three nodes, and the learning procedure have to be adapted somehow to learn these multi-word expressions. We can either tune extraction rules for any node covered in the multi-word expression and then merge the consequent words together, or we can develop something like look for a root of such multi-word expression, find rules for the root, and then when we have these rules and these rules identify the roots of such expression, use the whole subtree of the expression root as a result of the extraction. We use both approaches, and the approach based on root preprocessing and subtree postprocessing had better performance. So again, these rules are for discovering root of multi-word expressions, and these are just common rules for single word or single note expression. We didn't use multi-word expressions to identify injuries because it was always only a single word telling that this word was injured or this person behind the word was injured or dead. So this table summarizes results on our very small evaluation corpus of only 50 documents, and we evaluated we performed the evaluation on two tasks. First was to look for the amount of damage, and the second was to look for injured persons. And we compared our solution with a perceptron-like solution, which is available in the Gate software framework, and we obtained very similar results in our approach and the perceptron-like approach. I will first describe the results. So the rows ended with root. Is when the root subtree preprocessing postprocessing was used. So we can see that the root approach was much more better than the approach without root, and this rows tells us about lenient measures, which are more like not so strict. So even if there was some only overlapping annotations, like when you have multi-word expression, then if you have only one word correctly, then this evidence is called overlapping, and it's not exactly matching. And if we count these overlapping annotation like matching ones, then the precision recall measures are called lenient. I hope you understand what I mean. So these two rows represent the same experiment, but the second one is counted with lenient measures. Because there were much more rules, when we didn't do the roots of tree preprocessing and post-processing. We had for any of the multi-word expression, we had some rule, and then we usually some word of the multi-word expression was correctly. So the lenient measures are a little bit better than these strict measure for roots of tree preprocessing and post-processing, but we are usually more interested in the exact match than a partial match. So we think that these results are much better. Okay, leave that. Now comment on the perceptron-like learning. Perceptron-like learning is exactly the case when the classifier has only a single table with attributes, and one attribute is a class attribute. And the classifier has to decide which class attribute to assign to each row. And the only information the classifier has is the attributes in the table. So in this case, the table consists of attributes like which word was before the actual word, and which was two words before, and one word behind, and two words behind, and so on. So it's basically position-like approach, and it has only lemmas in the attributes, and I think some morphological, only lemmas, and here as the analytical function as well. And the perceptron approach with this simple information was quite successful, more successful than the inductive logic programming approach here, which had the whole lexicographical tree structure of all the sentences and so on. So we cannot say that the lexicographical or tree structure helped much to the information extraction in this very basic experiment. Here can be seen that the analytical function helped the classifier significantly, but it didn't use the tree structure. And now some implementation details about our approach. We used GATE from the University of Sheffield because it has some useful features for information extraction and so on. And I have a question, how many of you know GATE from Sheffield? Oh, only so few people. It is a graphical environment which allows you to label text and words in text and so on. And also it has many features that allows you compare different annotation sets on the same text. So you can easily evaluate your tools against the gold standard, and you obtain the performance measures, and you can also compare your algorithm with the perceptron-like algorithm I have showed, or some SVM-based algorithm, and so on. So we used GATE and integrated the TectoMT tools with gate. We do transformation of a result of TectoMT to gate annotations. We have also used NetGraph in gate, so it is possible to view the annotations in gate with NetGraph. This is a screenshot from gate with text analyzed by TectoMT tools, and it is designed like we have several types of annotation. Usually there are, when we do information extraction, there are not so many annotations on text. There are usually only some words decorated. But when we do a linguistic annotation, then we have a label for each sentence, a label for each token, and I decided to distinguish between tokens which are more from morphological layer and from analytical layer, and these from textogrammatical layer. So these are different types of annotation in gate. And the dependency annotations are also represented as label on text. Usually it's a label from the, when we have a dependency between two words, then the label or the annotation of the dependency covers the vortex between the two words. So we have many overlapping annotations for dependencies. I can do some live demo if we have time and the end of the presentation. So we have three kinds of dependencies. One is analytical dependencies between tokens. Second is textogrammatical dependencies between textogrammatical tokens. And we also have auxiliary references between textogrammatical nodes and textogrammatical tokens and tokens. There is also an editor for annotations, so we can, for a token of the word požár, we can select whatever is possible or view just. And there is the list of all annotations in text. So we have the token, which has the analytical function, form, lemma, so on. Dependencies have its arguments, which are identifiers of the child or parent-child annotations, and so on. Sentences have just the start and end offset. This conversion from TectoMT to gate was not so easy and straightforward as it could seem, because in the TectoMT there is no evidence of the start and end offset of each node in the original text, and we have to look up these offsets. And the text analyzed by TectoMT is often modified from the original one. So sometimes some words are elapsed from the original text, and the algorithm of looking for the three nodes in the original text has to be robust and to count with that some words were elapsed. Uh, Another thing is the integration of NetGraph to gate. We can just in the gate graphical environment open any word and it will be shown in a tree, and it is also usable to show Stanford dependencies in NetGraph, not only Prague dependencies. So this is basically all about integration with gate. Do I have some time for a live presentation or not? Okay. When I open gate, I can load a processing resource which is called TectoMT Batch Analyzer, and I can run just these two blocks for sentence segmentations and the numbers. Okay. I can create new document and put some text into it. This way I run TectoMT analysis on the text in the document, and if it ends, we should see these TectoMT annotations in gate. Let's see. There is one last topic about semantic web in my presentation, and it's about transformations of PML or PDP annotations to RDF, to semantic platform. It was quite easy with XSLT transformation to transform PML to RDF, and then it is possible to open the PDP annotations in any semantic tools like ontology editor. It is possible to do reasoning over annotated text and tree annotations. It is possible to ask semantic queries over the annotations. It is possible to use also visualization and navigation tools over the annotation, but I think the linguistically designed tools are much better for linguistic data, but then it is possible. In our research, we use reasoners to evaluation of extraction rules independently of the original tool which discovered the extraction rules. So the experiment was like this. We had a document annotated, then transformed to an ontology. And we have our information extraction framework, which produces extraction rules, which were also transformed to an ontology. And then when we merge these two ontologies with a reasoner, we obtained an annotated document ontology with results of extraction rule. This is a screenshot from ontology editor protege with linguistic data. There are the list of all tree nodes, and this one is selected. And it is of a class, I think, node and also a mention root. Mention root represents nodes which are relevant to the information extraction task, which are mentions of the information we are looking for. And this data type property mention root tells us that it is a root of an information of the image. So these decorated pieces of information were discovered by an over reasoner from Semantic Web 2. So this is how the discovered rules looks in Prolog environment. These rules are the same but transformed to an ontology. It is possible to keep similar rules in ontologies and then interpret them with a reasoner. So I will conclude that I presented a system for classical and semantic information extraction. It is based on third-party linguistic tools, mainly TectoMT and NetGraph. It uses inductive logic programming for automated learning of extraction rules, and all the tools are integrated inside the gate environment. Its main advantages is that it is not necessary to think about which linguistic features are good for the learning. The inductive logic programming procedure can decide itself which features to use in the extraction rules. It's in a sense language independent, and its rules, it's good for the semantic web environment and as also for human understanding of extraction rules. In the future work, we want to enhance the extraction technology with some knowledge base like WordNet. We want to work with other languages and datasets. The experiments with the corporate acquisitions dataset are not completed. And we want our method to provide more semantics. Now we are able to decorate some pieces of text, but we cannot really say that this piece of text, which is decorated like a date, we cannot really transform it to the actual date. We just know that here in the text is a date, but we don't know which day in the year is it exactly, and so on. So let's look if we succeed it, okay. And here is the annotated document. We have the sentence annotation, token annotations. We have also analytical dependency. And the programmatical dependencies. And when I open some token with graph, it's probably not working. Okay, better. So that is basically it. The extraction rules are based on the tectogrammatical structure and all the attributes. As we can see from the extraction rules, like here we use the tectogrammatical dependencies and all the attributes like lemmas and functors. Where is functor here? And so on. But all this information, we are using all this information, but the simple position-based approach was as successful, or maybe more, it's like very similar as ours. So we don't see the improvement from the position-based approach of perception. But I didn't get the question exactly. I expect much better success on languages with free word order. Yes, that's basically it. And I was also just curious if it will work and what will be the results. And that's the main motivation.
I don't want to answer your question because I don't know, but I would expect that what you miss in the text and you do not miss in the electrogrammatical piece are deletions on the surface. And on the surface sentence, if you look at the text from the surface point of view, there are many deletions and there are many bases. In the text, you have deletions. You don't mention, you don't have the mentions.
Yeah.
And with effective grammatical trees, you should have them. So I would guess that this might be one help which would add information which you might use for the purpose. But I don't know.
Yes, I agree with this, and I think there were some rules that actually matches even in the case when the word was missing but added to the taxogrammatical tree. But these cases are not so common, and in information extraction there is as well the problem that the general access of rules is usually about 50%, and it's a difficult task and so on. Usually the very simple approaches works very similar, like the very complex approaches. And
I would have a follow-up question. As far as I can understand, you work on sentences, I mean, from full stop to full stop. And I can imagine the information extraction problem as such is more general, because you may like to extract information, not just the one which is bounded by the full stops, but you would like to go further. And my question would be that if you, well, my guess again would be that if you, if we are so far as to have a discourse analysis, that you might get some profit out of it, because you might be, because when the, if we analyze discourse, at least at the stage we are, we put sentences, or we look for relations between sentences. And I think this might be also something which the future textogrammatical, beyond textogrammatical level might be going to.
Yes, there are usually in the information extractions very often coreference resolutions and anaphora resolutions is used, and there is a very big difference between get text annotated, just to say this word is this and this word is this, than to extract the annotations, because when an information in text is expressed duplicitly, like two people died and the driver something, then we can assume that there was actually three fatalities, but if we look at the coreferences between them, then we know that the driver is one of the two mentioned before. So the problem of information extractions is really difficult, and this is the way which will improve it. And so.